everything that I've built out of wood, you know, I sketch it out first with pencil and paper. And so the fact that it used the pencil made so much sense. My name is Morgan Hopfensperger. I live in Sanford, Florida, and I'm the creative director for a company called Microjig. I actually assist with the product development. I come up with ideas, I prototype them, and do a lot of the R&D and actually bring new products to market. I had been doing a lot of prototyping, just building stuff out of wood. And this was something that would be really difficult to build out of wood, and I kind of needed it to be a little bit more precise than I think I'd be able to get with it out of wood. I needed to be able to model something and then 3D print it from there. So we have a nice big CNC machine, and adding the 2D feature, being able to export a DWG or a DXF was huge when you guys released that, because I can model something, see what it looks like in three dimensions, and then actually run it out and then create vectors that I can bring into my CNC machine. And it all starts with the app. Our founder's name's Henry Wang, and he just kept coming up with different ideas for different processes in the woodshop. And really his kind of his design ethos is to come up with a solution that doesn't exist, that everybody's been doing it a certain way. And it's not just making a slightly improved version of something that already exists, it's completely overhauling how that process is actually done. All of our products, they come from a problem that you run into while you're trying to build something. You know, you run into a problem, and instead of Henry's, you know, thinking line of thought is, don't just come up with a workaround, like come up with a solution. You know, I wish there was a thing that did this or made this easier or faster or more accurate. And so that's kind of what gets his gears turning. And he just jumps on a computer and models out a few different ways that he can do it. We 3D print them and we test them. So really all of our ideas, both his and mine, come from just the actual process of woodworking and running into an issue. Our flagship product is called the Gripper, and it's a push block that you use on a bunch of different tools, but mainly the table saw, which has an enormous rate of injury. Every year there's over 50,000 injuries on the table saw. And so this product, the Gripper, makes using a table saw much, much safer. And so that would be if we had to communicate an overarching kind of end game in what we do, it's that we want to end table saw injuries all together one day. Kind of all of our products are intended to disrupt the status quo, disrupt the way that people have historically done certain operations. So we do see a lot of that. A lot of people are embracing our products and the new way that they are able to accomplish what they want to do. As far as like recent changes in the woodworking industry, the CNC market is growing so fast. There's so many consumer CNCs out on the market now that are affordable, and people are learning how to use CAD software like Shapr to basically do a portion of their woodworking, at least the design portion, on the computer. And then there's still a lot that you have to know to get the machine to cut stuff the way that you need to cut them. Just seeing the kind of digital revolution inch its way into woodworking. Up until I started using Shapr, it was really just Henry that was coming up with the ideas, coming up with the models, and having to make, you know, all those modifications to get them where we wanted. And so even just being able to assist in the R&D process or come up with a new idea that he can mess around with and be able to share them back and forth has been really, really helpful for at least for our business. Part of my job is just building stuff out of wood and showing people how to build it using our tools. So it helps me design wood pieces and gives me a much better understanding of what I'm actually going to end up with once it's finished. It's made 3D modeling accessible to somebody who had no experience. And, you know, I had looked at CAD software before, and it's intimidating. And so Shapr is just, it's made it accessible to 3D model something, and being able to 3D model something makes so many other things possible. You know, now I'm able to 3D print stuff. Now I'm able to use a CNC machine here. So it fans out, it branches out into all this new stuff that you can do once you understand how to make 3D models. Shapr 3D is, I think, has a huge potential to help woodworkers do what they do. Because, you know, the classic way has just been, you know, pencil and paper. For woodworking, there's so much detail that goes into designing something that you want to build that you miss things when you're doing it manually or when you're doing it on paper. And this just makes designing easier and actually, you know, it helps people save material by being able to lay stuff out before cutting anything. So I think that the woodworking market would really benefit from using Shapr3D.